case 60, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, okay. So first, what is your opinion about the intramural echogenic figures within? Which are these figures?
Like wall.
Yes, okay. Yes. So there are, I agree, there are similarly bright lines, for example here, and granules, so this is not a microcalcification. And most of these granules are located, or almost all, are located dorsal to tiny cystic areas. So these figures are not microcalcifications. The second, I stop the video. This is a combined type 1 and type 2 vascular pattern. The peripheral or perinodular vascularity can be seen at more than 55% of the circumference. But also the intramedullary vascularity is increased. The nodule lacks halo, but this proved to be a follicular adenoma. So this must be surrounded with capsule because this is a necessary definition of pathology. But we cannot see halo, cannot see the sign of capsule, or the perinodular vascularity can be interpreted as one form of a true capsule of a nodule. So indeed, I use vascularity for diagnosing follicular tumors, or not for diagnosing, but to exclude the possibility of follicular tumor. If I cannot see halo and cannot see perinodular blood flow, then the chance that the nodule would be a follicular tumor is less than 5%. I have already mentioned this observation in the previous webinars. I'll repeat myself. And regarding extratidal spread, naturally this did not spread extratidal, but you can see here the discontinuation of the capsule. Here is the capsule, here is again, and here the pseudocapsule is lacking. So once more, here is clearly capsule, here is clearly, and in great part of the ventral wall of the thyroid, the pseudocapsule is lacking. Okay, this case does not raise the possibility of extratidal spread, but I only mentioned. Here we can see around 1 or 2 millimeter distance between the ventral part of the thyroid and between the ventral wall of the nodule. So in these such cases, the risk of extratidal spread is minimal. But this case was illustrated not because of extratidal extension, but because of vascularity and lack of halo sign. Any questions, comments? This is not our current topic, but here we can see the tip of the needle. We have two signs of a successful aspiration. First, the movement of the needle. Here we will see, here, and the absolute proof is if we can visualize the tip of the needle. So this is not our current topic, but I mentioned questions, comments, concerns.
You want to do?
Please? Okay. No, I turn to the fourth case.